Good day from Chem Help ASAP. We know how to convert an alcohol into a halogen using something like HX, but sometimes you want to use different reagents, and there are actually other reagents that allow this transformation. So we're going to talk about non-HX methods for converting alcohols to halogens. So we're going to convert our OH to a halogen, that's supposed to be an X, but we're not going to use HX. So here is our kind of a cartoon of our transformation. Toward the top of the screen, I've shown a primary alcohol going to a primary halide. These methods will work for any substitution of halide. So there's a different set of reagents you can do for this. There's the traditional reagents. These are in all the textbooks. You'll find them all over the web. To convert the alcohol into a chloride, people typically say to use SOCl2. This is a reagent called thionyl chloride. We'll actually see it in different places in organic chemistry. Thionyl chloride. And that'll convert your alcohol into a chloride. There's another reagent for bromides. Phosphorus tribromide. I think most people just say PBr3. And so if you're going to use one of these reagents, you just write it over the arrow. PBr3 converts your alcohol to a halide, and of course not any halide X, but specifically to a bromide if you're using PBr3. There's not kind of a general iodide reagent that doesn't seem to bother people, but the direct conversions of all alcohols into halides, specifically an iodide, you don't see as much. Now, as you go through the literature, you find that these reagents, they don't always work that great by themselves. And so there are other more reliable reagents that I like to consider and that you see less on the internet, but based on the literature, these are much better reagents. And they're really easy to remember because they're all very similar. All of them involve using the dihalide, Cl2, Br2, or I2, with another reagent called triphenylphosphine. So PPH3, that's a capital P for phosphorus, and then a PH for phenyl, a benzene ring, and there's three phenyls. So that phosphorus is making three bonds. Those three bonds are to three different benzene rings, three phenyl groups. And these reagents, and there are about 100 variations of them, are really common ways to convert an alcohol, and let's just draw one of these, to convert an alcohol, whether it's primary, secondary, or tertiary. So let's say we do Cl2 and triphenylphosphine, we will get the chloride out of this reaction. But this is an important transformation. You have an alcohol, you want to do an SN1 or SN2 or an E1 or E2 on that alcohol, but alcohols are poor leaving groups. So you convert the alcohol into a good leaving group so you can go ahead and do your substitution or elimination reaction. And these are reagents that allow you to convert an alcohol into a halide regardless of the substitution.